excited you are. I would like you to gather around. This is my moment where I yank you out of the introvert zone. So then, folks, you stand up, looking at you in the back, and move yourselves closer to me. Penultimate part of the evening. So look, we've extracted a lot of money from you already. And I know that's asking a lot. That's great. Perfect. Why can't you be more like her? Unlike a lot of nerds and cons, I shower. And it's hard to part me for the money. Hang on, you're gonna need it. It's not going in my waistband, I promise.
Yes!
I extracted a lot of money from you. And I don't like doing that. For example, I won't sell my own books. I apologize to you that I hate being a salesman. So here I am standing on a table asking for your money. And I'm only doing that because what this charity does is so important. I want to reiterate that we are all here because we love science fiction and fantasy. We love comic books, we love video games, and the core of all of that is reading. It's how we all start. And we take it for granted. It's very hard for me to imagine people who don't have that option. The truth is they do, and they do here in the United States. There are people who do not have access to books, who do not have the literacy to participate in the worlds that we do. And I don't know about the rest of you, but if it hadn't been for these things for me, I wouldn't have made it. I wouldn't have made it out of my childhood. And so what I'm asking you to do during this auction is to dig a little deep. Yes, maybe it hurts a little bit. Because the money is not going to a vendor, the money is not going to enrich anyone. The money is going to make sure that this important charity, which is one of the very few of its kind, can continue to do its important work. And that's why you're here tonight, and that's why I'm asking you for this. So, we are going to start with auctioning off these glasses that you see in the back. They come as one set. They have been signed by every author at this convention. So whatever author you are here to see, was it John Scalzi? Was it Cory Doctorow? Was it Dale Carrier? Was it Christopher Paolini?
Yes!
It was Christopher Paolini. Sure as heck wasn't me, but it was. I signed there as well. Classic for everyone here. You can take them home and have them for the rest of your life. And we will open the bidding at $25. Do I hear $25? When I see $25 for this, do I hear $30? $30. And I get $40. $40 over here for this set of signed glasses. Can I see $45? $45? $50 over here on the side. Do I get $55 for the set of signed glasses? Can I get $60 for the set? $60! Outstanding. I'm loving this charitable spirit. You'll literally be drinking from the signatures of all of your favorite authors. Lots of people have autographed books. You will have autographed glasses. Do I hear $65? $65. I hear for $65. Am I gonna? $65 in the back. Do I hear $70? Can I get $70? Oh, you guys are making my heart grow three sizes. Outstanding. $100! I have to admit, I'm feeling a little inadequate right now. Not only are you like a solid foot taller than me, and there's a reason I'm standing on the table. Let's be frank. Will we take credit? Denise, we will take credit. We will take credit.
Okay, I'll up that to 200.
250! I promised myself I wouldn't cry. And I hate to keep asking for more, but this is an auction, folks. Can we get 255? Do I hear 255? Do I hear 255? I'm taking credit. I'm making uncomfortable eye contact. 255!
How about I make 255 and we auction it again?
Oh!
Starting a family with Pierce Brown, having three children, and picking their genders. $350. Do I hear 355? Do I hear 355? 355. 355 going once. 355 going twice. Sold for $355. He's really good looking. Like, when I met him, I really wanted to hit him. When you meet somebody that good looking, you're like, all right, well, he must be an idiot. And then you talk to him for 5 seconds, and you're like, no, no, he's a genius. Well, he must be a jerk. No, he's delightful. Well, he must be a terrible writer. How many of you have read Red Rising? Like, yeah, I give up. So he is literally a human being without flaw. But we beat his price, so that's something.
Absolutely.
Alright, next up, we're going to auction off that banner, which you see back there, which is also signed by all the authors, and which all of the authors have been photographed in front of, and that will go great hanging over your bed. So the first thing you see when you wake up in the morning is Thomas Kelsey's signature.
He's gonna turn purple.
Bring a little bit of Phoenix Comic-Con home with you. I will start the bidding at $25. Do I hear $25 for that banner? $25. Do I hear $30 going for that? $30 over there, sir. Do I hear $35 for this banner? It's autographed by everybody at this. $35. Do I hear $40? $40 for that banner in the back. Do I hear $45? Christopher Paolini, sir. $45. $50 for the banner.
I signed that darn thing. We all signed it. Buy it. Spend money for charity. You're a fantasy signed by all of the fans. Come on, you can do this.
$100. $105. Can I hear $110? This is $110, Christopher Paolini. Look, you may not know him. He does not get on tables and yell frequently. In fact, this may be the first time. Also, this table is not nearly 100% stable.
No more.
Sorry, maybe I should stop pacing. We have it at 110. You are here at 115. 115. You just got yelled at Christopher Becker. 115. Do I hear 120? 120. Do I hear 125? Can I get one? 125. Maybe Sylvain had a indigestion there or something, but I heard it. And that's enough for me to bill him.
And that saw song.
Do I hear 130? 130. God bless you. I don't know who you are, but you and I are friends. Just a reminder, at 6 p.m. on Friday. Yeah. 6 p.m. Saturday will be the author Basu. We should see all the great authors. My advice for this one, it's a game show where you have to avoid, not win, but avoid losing so you don't get punished. Get there early, the room fills up, you do have to turn people away, I'd rather not have that happen. So if you're here now, you're all my best buddies, make sure you get there. The bidding was at 135, do I hear 140? 140, bless you in the back, 140 in the white hat. Do I hear 145? 145! Man, every time I think we've reached our ceiling, we keep pushing. 150! Get 150! Outstanding! 155! Every author, 155 in the back! Can we go to 160? 160! 160! 160! This, folks, is what we call a war. But unlike bad wars, nobody dies and kids get to read. 165! I hear 165, 165, 165. Does anybody give me 165? No. 165. Can we go to 170? 170. Where 175? 175. 175. 175. Do I hear 180? 180. 180. 180. Do I hear one? Let's go in $10. It's 190. Do I hear 190? 190. 190. 190. 190. 190. 190. 190. I'm not. 190. Do I hear $200? 200. We have to make it even, of course. This is just an issue of symmetry. It's not even down to raising money now. It's just keeping things even. 215. Do I hear 215? 215, 215, 215! Can we get 240? Do I hear 240, 240, 240, 240, 240? Have I 240? There's a small increment, but we have to keep things even. Do I hear 250? Oh, we gotta get 250. This is a matter of symmetry.
Mike, you can have a never-raised dog tag. There are 150 of these in the world.
This is
added to the poster.
All right. Well, what am I putting up here?
So this is a, if you read the Themis Files, this isn't, we're getting a Kara Resnick dog tag as a pre-order promo. This is an Eva Reyes dog tag from Waking Gods and Only Human. And there are 150 of those in the world. 23 of them are for me and my son. So you do the math, whatever.
All right, this has been added to the lot. If we can get to 250. 250, outstanding. Do I hear, and I'm going to move it bigger increments now, I'm going to hear 275. And 275 for symmetry. So hey, this is fantastic.
How about 900?
No.
Is that a bid?
That's ambitious. Romina, are you still mad about the singing?
I'm a little mad.
You're, she's still a little mad about the singing. Do you think you would be less mad if I kicked that drink all over you, for which I apologize? Do you think you would be less mad if we got the rid of it here?
I would forgive you.
Okay, guys, I don't know if you saw how pissed Romina was when you went up there and made her sick.
She slapped me, though. She's like,
yeah. Right, so she hits Sylvain, and I'm not sure what my future holds. And if you don't want to find me in a dumpster, $300, right? $300! Can someone please tweet him and let him know that he has been beaten twice? 325, do I hear 325? Thank you, it has been treated to Pierce Brown.
I thought you said porn.
$400!
I heard porn.
The porn is yours.
That is a terrible idea, Christopher. The porn gets thrown in. Do I hear $400? For $400, the porn joins. $400! Woo! So, can we get 425? I'm so sorry to keep pushing. But this is for 425! Sylvain will throw in, we can get it to 450, all of his clothes, and he'll leave the hall naked! $450! For $450!
You want 10 bucks, I'll throw in the one.
Are you
going
to sign it?
For
I'll sign
for
one.
Folks, be nice to him. He's Canadian. $450! Do I hear $450? Do I hear $450? $450! For $500, Christopher Paolini has offered to do a cartwheel. Now, he did not offer this, but I'm in charge. We will film the cartwheel. We will tweet the cartwheel. And the whole world will see. And they will know that you made this happen for $500! Can I get $500? Is there anyone in the audience who will see $500? $500! Meanwhile, Sylvain is disrobing, giving the deed to his house, and signing his $1 bill. Don't forget, Christopher, we finished this. You're cartwheeling on camera. And Romina, you are no longer allowed to hurt me. Because maybe I won't make you happy. No, Sylvain, we were kidding. We were totally kidding. We were kidding. How about the forest? What about the rest?
You never.
Okay, folks. In order to get Sylvain to keep his clothes on, for the love of God, At this point, I'm really begging you. Because look, I've been to War 3 times, I've seen a lot. And I had a feeling this is going to push the envelope, something fierce. $525 for Sam Keep's clothes on. $525, do I hear $525? Do I see a hand for $525? We are still at $500. $500 going once. $500 going twice. Sold for $500. Thank you. I want to thank all of you for digging deep and for coming out tonight. This is wonderful. And a big hand to Kids Need to Read.
Absolutely.
Oh, excuse me. Hold on. It looks like we have one more.
Mike!
There he is.
We got to watch the
cartwheel.
Wait,
wait. There he is. Oh, we have the cartwheel. There's cameras on that
cartwheel. Okay.
Oh! I want to see tweets tagging that man. I want that on the gram. I want that show. We have one more lot to auction off.
You signed $1 bill.
Yes, I signed $1 bill.
And the board.
Four. Thank you very much.
We have one more lot to auction off. I apologize for saying this is part of it.
The Holy Grail right there.
I don't know how many people grew up with Charles and Schultz's Peanuts and Logan. This is where I learned that adults don't actually speak. They just go womp, 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 womp. This is where I learned that doghouses were made to fly. We have a special edition of a complete collection of Charles M. Schultz's Peanuts. This is every strip in all of the books. I am guessing by looking at it, this is probably a $200 value.
Yeah, it's freakishly awesome.
So let us begin the bidding as I have with all the other lots for $25. Do I hear $25? $25! Can I hear $30? $30 for the booster. $30. Do I hear $35? $35. Do I hear $40? Do I see $40? Do I hear $45? $45. Do I hear $50? $50. God, you guys make me happy. $55. $250. Well, so they just made it interesting. The bid on the floor is $250. I think this man wants to go home, but he will go home wearing all his clothes, thanks to you. $275 in the back, God bless you. Do I hear $300? $300 for this complete collection of Charles M. Schultz Peanuts books. Do I hear $300? The bid stands at $275. $275 going once, $275 going twice. Sold for $275. Thank you, folks. See you in the back. Now I will say thank you so much. Thank you for coming. Thank you for hanging out with us. And thank you most of all for supporting Kids Need to Read. It's a really great charity.